say which parameters they have taken into consideration while, you know, putting across this fact that 9 out of 10 are unhappy. What are the basis of that unhappiness? What are the factors which were taken into consideration?
Just like that. Boredom. Marriage, they say, is boredom sticking to the same. Like, you know, it's not marriage, is not that. But suppose you and me, we are friends. For 1 year, we spend that after, in the period of time, you get bored of me, I get bored of you. So marriage is not involved, sex is not. It's a question of boredom.
See, I'll tell you something. When we talk about boredom,
they are bored.
Yeah, but then there are ways out. You can work out that problem.
Maybe the boredom is the main cause of unhappy marriage.
No, I would not say that. Boredom is not the cause of unhappy marriage.
Every day, same man, same.
I think
yes. A kind of yes.
It's an attitude problem.
No, and basically, I tell you what happens. We actually don't know how to lead a proper married life. The problem lies over there. We have no idea of what marriage is. We are thrown into this institution of marriage and we are left to explore it on our own. We don't even know what to do with ourselves. There are so many couples who come to me, you know, where the husband says, I cannot live without my wife. Even when she goes to her mother's place, I don't know what to do. I said, how can you make a statement like that? If she's away at her mother's place, you have to be individually very happy with yourself. She has to be very happy herself, and then only jointly you can give happiness to each other. Now, problem lies is the man is unhappy in his own way, the woman is unhappy in her own way. So how do you expect each of them to make the other person happy? You have to enjoy your own company before you enjoy your partner's company.
That's what the Osho was saying.
Yes.
Love yourself.
Yes, exactly. And that is what happens. People with low self-esteem, when they marry, or people when they don't have a proper sense of self-worth, when they marry, they neither care about themselves, let alone caring about their partner. This is where the problem lies. And that is why I strongly insist that in many cases, you need counseling rather than medications. Every sexual problem or anything cannot be solved by medicines. You need proper counseling and it works wonders. But in our country, there are no government rules which would allow you to practice as a sex therapist. No, we cannot practice as a sex therapist in the way the therapy should originally or actually work. We cannot even show them certain images because they think it's erotic and it's pornographic, according to their definition. So we can just orally explain to a couple that this is what you need to do, because otherwise there is a ban on sex therapy in our country. Unlike in Europe and America, where you have people like Helen Singer Kaplan, who is such an accomplished woman and who has done wonderful work in the field of sex therapy. Or even one, Dr. Ruth, she's also an excellent sex therapist, where she has such a wonderful clinic and you have both men and women flocking to her clinic. But we don't have, you know, this kind of permission is not given by our medical body. So we have to be very, very limited in our scope and probably just talk more without, you know, like going much deep into the therapy.
See, one question here.
Yes.
You said working
women,
working couples, nowadays divorce crazy. What is the reason behind it?
Sorry, your question?
You are working couples.
Okay, I'll tell. Yes. Do you have to say anything?
This I have read.
Okay.
We are very competitive. Say
50, 60 years ago, divorce rates was very high in Parsis and Catholic. That was because of our thinking.
But Roman Catholics were never allowed to be divorced.
Now, Hindus are looking for divorce. At the end of divorce.
See, coming to his question, why the rates of divorce are very high, one reason, as I said...
Now this is happening in Hindus.
Yes.
Before,
they
were dependent. Yes. Also say this.
Now, every 50 years, divorce is the rate of Parsis was there, Catholics was there, but now everybody at the same level.
No, and you know, I'm basically very caste-free person, you know.
But caste does play a part.
No, I'll tell you why. See, one of the reasons... No, it's not that. It's not that. If you look at Dolly Thakur... See, let me give an example. When you talk about people in the past, actually, you know, we always associate very good things with the past. You look at Dolly Thakur, she's a theater personality. She is nearly 70 now. And she divorced nearly 50 years ago. She belongs to your age group, or probably slightly older to you. Or you take even certain, you take Suchitra Sen, the legendary Bengali actress Suchitra Sen. When she was in her early 20s, she divorced from her husband. So there have always been these sporadic cases of divorce, but these women have been, they were empowered even at that time. Or you even take the case of Aparna Sen, where she's married thrice. But she, basically, as she said, that she was an emancipated woman, she had that financial power, and she could live life in her individual way. Now coming to his question, why divorces are happening more these days? First reason, as she said, is there is emancipation on the woman's side. Earlier, what used to happen, that she would take in a lot of nonsense from everybody, because she was dependent on the man. Now since she is earning, she has a way out of the problem. So now if she has a major problem, if there is physical violence involved, and it's healthy also, that you know, rather than being beaten for the rest of your life, for her own safety and for her own mental health, I would also advise that she should separate if these are the situations. And another reason is, as I said earlier, people have become very, very self-centered. I want my own freedom even after getting married, which is not possible. Let me tell you that. Today, like if you are a single male, even if you walk out of the house at 2 p.m., nobody is going to tell you anything. But then, if you are married, you owe an explanation to your partner that what are you going out and doing at 2 p.m. Right? And same is with the woman. If she is married and if she says that, you know, I'm going to stay in the office for the whole night, she has to tell her husband why she's staying out. If she's single, she is not answerable to anyone. So there the understanding problems are created. Where, you know, the wife is saying, no, I'm also going to be out, the husband's going to be out. There is lack of communication and time. There is no quality times being spent together. So there are a lot of differences of opinion which are never being patched together. And most of the cases, what happens, like the wife has a lover in the office, the husband has a lover in his own office. So rather than communicating with their spouses, they are communicating with their lovers more than their own spouses. So that is creating a bigger rift. And also there is one more factor, like earlier we used to be living with relatives. Now we don't live with relatives. We have our own apartment, husband, wife and maybe children. So there is no social threat. There is no social barrier to stop these people from, you know, separating. It's like, okay, you go your way, I go my way, we are both fine. That is what is happening.
And financially it is a sound? Because of it happening?
No, I would not. That's not the only reason. No, but then I also believe that, you know, no, but then see, no, but then tell me something. As a human being, we need to be sensitive to the needs of the woman. As a human being, you can't expect a woman to be bashed up every day by the husband and take it lying down. That is not really good for her physical health or her mental health. So we need to understand that. I do understand that if, you know, like if we are fighting for the wrong reasons, yes, the woman is wrong. But if she's regularly being harassed or beaten up, I think she has every right to walk out of the house. Because that is basically about her own dignity. So we need to respect her for that, but not for other reasons. If she doesn't have a valid reason, there should be some form of adjustment. Any other questions? Yeah, see, actually we were supposed to have the topic of bedroom etiquette for couples, but since we had a different age group today, we were expecting a age group. Sure. Yeah. We were expecting a different age group. So now we are basically having a discussion of any sexual questions you would have, and I'm trying to answer them for all of you. So you could have any questions you want, and I would try to answer them for you. That is how we are working today. No, we are not doing that. Any questions, anybody else? It could be related to anything about yourself, your friends, and of any age group.
Sir, is sex life necessary to make the marriage happy?
Yes.
After, let's say, 50 or 40?
It is.
After 40?
Yes.
What?
No, ideally, I tell you something. You know, we think sex is something very physical. We always think it's very physical, but there it is a way of communicating between the man and the woman. The more sex you have with your partner, the more your bonds of intimacy would get strengthened. And it's also good for your health because, you know, if you're having sex till old age, your prostate gland will work more properly.
Emotional attachment is
Yes. Your prostate health will improve. If you stop having sex, there will be a lot of prostatic congestion. So it's better that you know, you continue to have sex for as long as you can have, or you know, at least have some form of sex. And don't believe in what people say, like, you know, that you have to stop having sex at a certain age. That's all hogwash and deception. That's all hogwash. Yes. No, no. You can continue to have sex for as long as you want. His question is that should a woman continue to have sex after menopause? The answer is yes. Yeah, some of them yes, definitely. Because there is no fear of pregnancy. So she would actually enjoy it. Okay, that's a very good question. See, basically, you know, yes, his question.